Now we slide this in nice and slow in the cover of night. There we go. Hello, everybody. Grace Two Plays. We're checking out a game for the channel called Motorbike Mechanic Garage Simulator. The developer got with me and sent me this game early so I could check it out. I have links in the description below if you want to check it out. This is our garage where we must fix all manners of motorbikes, and there have you. Not all of them are busted. Like, I already did a little tutorial just to kind of teach me how it goes. And all I had to do was repair some footrests and stuff like that. Now, it did mention to check around the garage because you'll find things of interest besides this lovely beer sign, which I do enjoy. Beer. It's the reason I get up every afternoon. They said that there would be valuable things. I see, like, just stacks of cash. Yeah, there's just stacks of cash laying around the garage. So give me a second while I pick up all these dollars and coins in there, Abby, because there's no reason to leave them hanging around. We've got 25 grand sitting on us right now. Now, I don't know yet. I just started playing this, so I don't know yet what sort of upgrades and various things we can do to the garage. The garage already looks pretty legit. I mean, it's a decent size. Normally in Car Mechanic Simulator, we were given like a very tiny area to begin with that we could expand as time went on. Oh, I got the Cash Stash Bronze Trophy achievement. What does that mean? I just found enough money in the game for me to continue to get various achievements. Oh, there's a door over here. There's a painting area where you can do painting for the parts and stuff like that. What's upstairs? What in the holy hell? Oh, it's just sound effects for outside. Got it. Oh, we got a back room over here. It's just a lion on the wall. It says lion. We got a back room over here. I didn't even know about this. So, yep, more money laying around. We got ourselves a, I guess it looks like a printer over here. What is this? Oh, it's where all your achievements go as you do things in the game. They actually sit here on the wall. That's actually pretty cool. I enjoy that. I like that the stuff that you do, besides getting the little achievement in the bottom right-hand side of the screen, is legitimately, like, recognized within the game itself. More money on the old captain's chair over here. And I think there's some dollars a little bit in the distance. And after we've scraped up all this money, we might as well go ahead and take a new job. Now, the jobs, it seem like, you get a whole slew of them, and you get to pick from which ones you want. They come in on a cell phone. Where did I put that damn cell phone? It's like real life. Here we go. They come in on a cell phone. We also have this computer over here. One of the very few games, I gotta show you this, where it lets you pick your background. So you can legitimately have different background types for your computer over here. We got Frozen Monkey, which is all the parts come from. We have the available parts, which is where we have extra parts. We take apart motorcycles and keep the old parts and stuff like that. This is where they sit, which I think I actually have. Yeah, in available parts, you can check the parts if you have them. And I think we have some right now. If I go to footrests, yeah, we have these old footrests over here. You can see every part in a 3D image. You can move in and move back and kind of like cant it around and stuff like that. So that's pretty slick. Down here, and I know this is like, I don't know if I would consider this cheating. I don't think it is because I would have to do this in real life anyway. It creates a list for you to show you what parts you need for each job. And I kind of like that. So old Gray doesn't have to take his old pen and paper out and write down the 200 different motorcycle parts that I'm going to need to fix something. All right, away from the computer, over to the cell phone. Let's freaking grab something. So we have a few things over here. They're all changed parts. This one's worth $500. So I'm assuming that it's like the craziest one there is. Let's take an easy one first, and then we'll take a hard one, and we'll see what the difference is. Both of them get us 5 XP. Now, XP you get to level up, and again, it said that there's a bunch of upgrades in there, heavy, that you can get with your hard-earned money and XP. All right, I have a problem with my motorcycle. Will you help me? All right, so this one just needs footrests. If we decline it, does it just go away, or is it still there? Like, if I decline this, what happens? Oh, wow, okay. It legit just flat out leaves. So let's take the next one for sure. I have a problem with my motorcycle. They need turn signals. Okay, that doesn't seem too bad. TS832. So let's go ahead and accept this. Let's get out of here. And now the motorcycle should appear in the shop. There it is, baby. There's yonder chopper. Now, I don't know how many different models there are of motorcycles, because again, I've only messed around with one so far. So let's take a good long look at this. Oh, we have to make sure the part matches the original part paint job wise. So for the footrest, they're just black. So hopefully there's not going to be too much that we'll have to do with them. So we head over here, and now once we click on the motorcycle, there's a couple of different things that we can do. We can turn this off as well, and I think I am, because for the most part, I remember what all this is. All right, there we go. So now we don't have to have that crap in the way. So we can zoom in a little bit more if we wanted to. It says that there's like 100 or 200 parts or something like that for all the different items in the motorcycle. I can already see quite a few. I'm curious how much to the engine there is. I can already see there's a spark plug. There's the end of the ignition cable. For right now, though, we got simple stuff to do. So let's go ahead and remove the footrest. You can see the upper part of the screen, disassembly, assembly, disassembly preview, and assembly preview. All we need is the disassembly for right now. So let's go ahead and remove these. I imagine there's four of them because there was last time. Move around the motor. Now, can you teleport into the motorcycle and see the innards? Oh, you sure can. That's what I'm talking about. Got the oil tank in here, the oil pipe, the coil holder element. All right, looking good. All right, let's get the rest of these footrests off. All right, so with the footrests off, we got to get over here. I think that sound is new jobs coming in as well. We've got to get over here. We've got to come over to our computer. We need to, now remember, we can see what exactly, I'm a freaking jackwagon. I've been taking off footrests and I was supposed to be taking off turn signals. 1 second. That's right, good sir. Your footrests are looking very, very dapper, fantastic. I was just giving them a real quick inspection. All right, very thorough over here in the garage. Okay, I'm not gonna let you walk out of here with craptastic footrests. Okay, let's go over to the turn signals and take off what we're supposed to take off. All right, turn signal over here. Oh, this part is too damaged to use again. Okay, so I guess we're gonna have to just get rid of it or whatever. All right, very good. So those two are gone, and I think that's all that there is. I'm pretty sure that's it. Anything else that we're supposed to remove would be in green, which is odd because the footrests were in green. Usually you don't see that. Usually everything that you're not supposed to remove shows up in red. Like these cables over here are in green, which is kind of odd. So I think what it is if you find things like this that aren't in good shape, I think you can take them off and replace them for extra money. But right now though, I'm just gonna go ahead and utilize the turn signals because that's what the guy wanted. So over here in Frozen Monkey Land, we need parts needed for tasks. TS-832. Okay, so let's find out where the turn signals are. Looks like everything is, for the most part, pretty well separated from each other. All the way at the bottom here, turn signals. So this is how many different types of parts and items there are. Decent amount, it looks like, so far. Like I said, it remains to be seen what the engine repair looks like. But for right now, we've got these. So let's go ahead and buy this. This is what we're looking for over here. So we're going to go ahead and buy, I guess we need at least two of them. Here we go. Over to the motorcycle, over to the assembly mode. And now all we have to do is just loom in the area where the turn signals go, and they should go right in. Oh, and if you're wondering what the preview mode is, again, it's kind of like a little cheaty thing, but I would consider it maybe like looking at a diagram or your diagnostics book or something like that. Because if we press on it, we can see exactly where the items that it wants us to attach go. Turn signal number one, turn signal number two, and that should be it. Everything should be completely fine now. Let's see if we can turn this in for the money. Go rock over here to the phone. And let's see over here. Change parts, okay, and then finish, and we should get it. Yeah! We get the sound of the beautiful engine blasting our eardrums out. We've reached a higher level. We got another 5 experience points, and we have some more jobs over here. So this one's worth that 498. Let's take that one and see what it does. It needs new mirrors. Okay, so mirror 1022. Doesn't sound like a big deal for the most part. I'm gonna go ahead and grab it. Oh, let me really show you boys something else, too. So over here in the computer, we have eBay, or Yeebuy, I guess. You can double-click on this, and we can actually sell the old stuff that we had picked up. You're gonna notice we still have those old footrests that we had picked up, and we still have the old turn signal that we picked up. So we can go ahead and sell it, and we'll see what we get for it, I guess. What do I go down here and click on it? Okay, we get 19 bucks. I think you get half the price of the normal item to do it. Oh, here we go. Sell. Got it. Okay, so click it. Sell. There we go. And then if you want, you can go to buy. And every once in a while, there's all kinds of random items over here. Now, it says that they're random. You're not always going to find what you want. But sometimes if you want to save some cash, you can find it on Yeebuy. And we can hit it up here for just to save us, I guess, some dough. So here's the new motorcycle. Now, supposedly, The different types of jobs that there is there's part replacement, maintenance, and then I think like building a vehicle completely from scratch from the specifications of the customer. But building this from scratch would be pretty cool. I think I'd like to try that at some point. It would probably be kind of cumbersome, but it should be worth a ton of money. Now for this job, it's said to remove the mirrors. But we can't take these mirrors off. We have to remove other stuff first, it looks like. So do you have to remove everything? Oh, I see. We have to remove the cable. We probably have to get rid of the brakes or something like that in order to get this thing off. Grab this cable over here. Okay. What else do I have to remove? Ah, the hand grip. All right. Take the brake lever out. Now can we get the mirror? No. Oh, it was this tiny ass screw in the back. I had no idea that right down to the screws you had to do. All right. So now we know. So we probably removed a bunch of stuff that we didn't need to remove, I would guess. Like, can I? Yeah. We could just go back here. Okay, it just slides right out. That's fine. I could replace the other items. All right, don't worry. I made it right. Everything's fine. Okay, so now over to Frozen Monkey. Parts needed M1022 for the mirrors. Let's go down to the mirrors section over here. There they are. And then we need, oh crap, there's actually, not the oil tank. There's actually quite a few mirrors. 1022, there we go. That's the kind we want. So let's go ahead and grab these right quick. I wonder if this is a real website. dev4play.com. Is this like the developers or something like that? I'm very curious right now. All right, let's get out of here. Now, I only bought one set because I think that this set gives you both the mirrors that we're going to need, and it shouldn't be any kind of big deal. Over to the assembly mode. Loom over here where the mirror should go on. Yep, let's go ahead and grab it. Place it, and now we have to drill in the screw back here, like as we do. Sounds like we're freaking using an air tool on it. I don't know if we need anything that heavy duty, but whatever. Another mirror. Throw that on over there. Give me my money, baby. These mirrors. Oh, you know what? I just thought about this. These mirrors might not be the right color. We should check that out first. Over to the painting room. Damn it. 1022. Let's check it out. So we have to match the colors. The required color is this tan. Now, you can do this one of two ways. You can do it yourself and drive yourself completely insane, or you could use the matching dropper tool. I'm going to give it a shot and see if I can get this before I go insane. Oh, I got it. You just had to get close enough. All you had to do is just get the circle to turn green. So we did it. We saved $100. That's not too bad. All right. We got her done. That's both of them, right? Okay, good. Just making sure that everything was 100% done. Back over here. Yeah, see, they didn't match before. It looked like crap. Now we slide this in nice and slow. In the cover of night. There we go. Now it looks legit on this thing. Second one over here. Put it on down. I wonder if we get like bonus money or anything, or if you just lose money if you don't get it precisely right. Let's go ahead and use our overpowered air tools to put the last tiny ass little screw in, because why not? Over by the phone. And this should be time to turn this thing in. Let's see, your motorbike position 2. That's the one we have right now. Finish it. Fantastic. All right, what's next over here? $1,500. Now we're getting somewhere. Plus, we get 12 XP for this one. I want to try this one. I want to do harder and harder over here. So now we need a new seat and then a front light for $1,563. I feel like, is that overpriced for work on a motorcycle? I've never owned a motorcycle, and I've only played the car mechanic simulator. Well, we've done train mechanic simulator. We did that too. But I feel like, is this price appropriate? The developer said they went to motorcycle garages and like watched them work and stuff like that. So I don't know if these numbers are appropriately representative of the work that you would do for this particular type. I mean, I guess it depends on how good the motorcycle is too. Here's the motorbike. Does it look like an expensive one? Does it look pretty legit? I don't know, man. Looks pretty nice, actually. We got this all chromed out and stuff like that. All right, let's take off the front light. And I think it was just the seat, and we should be good to go. All right, so front light. What sort of interesting objects? Ah, take the nut off over there. Take the nut off over there, and the front light slides right off. Okay, that wasn't that bad at all. And then the seat. Now, what is holding this on? Again, you'll have to forgive my lack of motorcycle knowledge. Like I said, I played Car Mechanic Simulator, and I wasn't a super impressive, knowledgeable car guy. But it was cool because I got the opportunity to learn a lot about cars by playing the mechanic simulators. That's kind of why I enjoy playing these particular types of games, because it could teach me stuff. I saw some screws back here that we can remove. All right, so we've got two screws on this frame over here. Let's go ahead and grab those. Now, can you take the seat off? Yeah, the seat comes right off after that. Okay, no big deal. So that part's too damaged to use. We're all done over here. It should just be the seat and the front light. Let's go to eBay. Maybe we'll find these over here. Front light, FL213 and the CS1030. Sure. What do we got over here? Front light. I'm not really seeing any front lights. Frame, footrest, yeah, foot star. Luckily, they're all in alphabetical order. Oh, thank you so much, developer, for friggin' doing that. No. Nothing's here that we need. So we're gonna have to buy them brand new from the parts store. So, actually, all we have to do, bring that down, get out here, go over to Frozen Monkey. There we go. So now we can see them. Front light, seat, FL213. Just give you a little look at what it looks like. Pretty standard. Let's go ahead and buy that for $52. So is that the appropriate price for a light, I wonder, in that case? And then a CS1030. Bring ourselves down here to the CD area. I wonder, like, is this... Wow, is the better number mean a better seat? Is this a more comfortable seat than this one? Oh, wow. Actually, you know what? Let's take a look at the different seats over here. I'm curious what some of them look like. So far, the 1030 looks pretty legit. That one looks all right, too. I kind of like 630 over here. All right. I don't know. Which seat would you guys go for if you had to go for any one of these over here? Looks like a bike seat, almost. Let's go ahead and grab this one, though. $1,199! Jesus! I mean, we're getting paid, but we're making like $350 or something like that from this case. Back over to the motorcycle. Over in front over here to the assembly mode, we should be able to just slide this on. There we go. And now there was two bolt nuts over here that we have to put on. There they are. There they are. One over there. One over there. And now the seat should also slide right on. And there was only two bolts as well on the underside that attach to the frame right there. All right. And we're set to go. I'm pretty sure that's it. Oh, and just so you guys know, so I'm not screwing this guy over, I looked to see what colors we were supposed to use. We're using the right colors, so everything's fine on the seat and the light. So change parts, finish, yeah! Now that's some cash over there. How much money do we have right now? We made about, because we started with 25 grand, made about $689 so far. So what else do we have over here? A job worth 422. Can I get rid of this job? Because this job is still here, if you notice. This message is identical to the one you're reading now. Thanks. I guess. Oh, there we go. We got rid of it. Okay, so now we deleted it and it's replaced with a new job. This one's $422. So that's a new number. We haven't seen this one yet. Hello, boss. Smiley face emoticon. I would like to change some parts on my motorcycle. Handlebar levers and a horn. Sure, for $422. Let's freaking do it. Now we've got some eclectic tastes over here. I like this coloration. Even look at this. The fenders and everything. All right, go up on the stand over here. So the handlebar levers and the horn. So this is the clutch lever, and then I think we should have the brake lever. So I'm assuming it means these two. I believe, anyway. Oh, here we go, the front brake lever. Yeah, that's what I was saying. So these two and then the horn, I would assume? The horn is looming around down here, and it's connected to something. So let's kind of wander our way down here. So now remember, the cool thing is that if even a random schlep like me can figure out what is bolting this thing in, anyone can do it. Now there's a nut back here, and this is probably what we're looking for. Yep, right over there. Okay, horn is off. And now, like I said, I assume it's these levers that it's talking about. If it's not, then I guess I get more experience in taking the different parts of the motorcycle off. Cables, handlebar, clutch lever. Okay, so that's definitely it, because it wouldn't say that if we weren't supposed to take that off. Cable, hand grip. Oh, this is something else. Another cable, front brake lever. Perfect. Okay, we've got everything that we need. That's the little symbol of, I think that's the save feature. I think that's what that is. All right, we're over here in eBay. Just to see if we can save some money again, because I'm very curious over here. There is a horn for sale. Is it the right horn? It is not. That's not what we're looking for. And then the handlebar levers, it doesn't appear to have either of those. Spend some cash, boys. You got to spend money to make money over here. 418, got it. There's the horn that we're looking at. So let's go ahead and buy one of those. That's 418. And then handlebar levers, CLFBL703. So this one right here, I'm pretty sure this is what we're looking. Yeah, that's definitely it. And it looks like it gives you both. So there's nothing else we're going to need. We only need this one set over here. So I guess the handlebar levels, the levers come in a set. Even though you can take them off individually and you can see which one is which, it looks like it's a specific set that you can purchase and it gives you both in one shot. Over here in the assembly area, let's go ahead and start putting everything back on. Totally forgot about this. Had to make sure to do it real quick. We got to match the colors. So this looks like maybe we'll start right over there. We'll see how good old Gray's eyes are on this. How quickly I can come into contact with the right color. I think we're getting close. I just gotta match the numbers. We needed less blue. Look at that. Right off the bat. Freaking got it. Boom. Right there. So now that we have that done, we also need the horn. All right, so what colors are we dealing with the horn? Oh, same color. Now I think we can just do this. Yeah, because we've already matched it one time, so it doesn't cost any money for us to do it again. We don't have to take the $100 to do this. So then we're gonna go ahead and do that there. And now we're set to replace all this stuff and send it back to the customer. All right, loon down here. Horn slides on. Now, there was a nut that we have to make sure to get. There we go, back here. And now for the handle clutch. And now for the handle levers. I think they call it the handlebar levers, but they're separate. And then there was, what was there? There was at least one wire here. Yeah, there's one wire on this side. I think there was two wires on the brake lever side. So let's go ahead and slide that in. And then the two levers, or the two cables, I should say, right over here. There was one, and then the other one I think is on the other side. I think I have to go this way in order to grip it. Speaking of grips, can't forget that. And here's the last cable. And that should be it. I'm pretty sure that's everything. The customer should be happy. All the paint is correct colors and everything. Back over here to the phone. Back over here to the part area. And then, yep, everything's checked off. 11 XP. Guys should be happy. The motorcycle doesn't have all the parts attached. What the hell did I take off that I didn't put back on? Oh, I totally forgot. The other hand grip. Okay, so it doesn't allow you to give it back to the guy if you don't have all the items attached. Well, that's nice because I would have hated for the dude to come in and be like, hey, I think we may be missing something that's of vital importance. There we go. Now we got the money. Now we got the XP. So there we go. Just giving you guys a little bit of a show of what this particular game is like. Like I said, we didn't get into making a full motorcycle yet, but that would probably come later. What do you guys think of Motorbike Garage Mechanic Simulator? I feel bad. I think I called it like Motorbike Mechanic Garage Simulator. It's a giant mouthful no matter what. One thing I'd like to see happen is if there was like extra things that you could use your experience for. I don't know if there is yet. I don't know if there's like an upgrade tree or anything like that, but I haven't found it. Feel free to let me know what you thought about it in the comment section below. Until the next time, folks, stay foxy and much love.